Well, Judge, the last time we spoke about the ability for Democrats to convert political cash into a government-sponsored warrant to spy on members of the Trump transition team, you said you wanted to see people led away in handcuffs, not just fired, but led away in handcuffs. Well, you know what? The FBI and the Department of Justice aren't going to be putting the handcuffs on themselves, so we need a second special counsel, just as Congressman Lee Zeldin has recommended, so that we can take the findings of the IG report, we could take the information we've learned in congressional hearings, and we can actually have prosecutions. Because my fear is that if we don't have a second special counsel, this will turn out a lot like the Benghazi investigation, where we learn a lot of bad facts, but no one's really held accountable. You mentioned Andrew McCabe earlier. His testimony before the Judiciary Committee in closed session showed me that Hillary Clinton was never really put in jeopardy as a result of her use of a private email server and the leaking of classified information, because she had people that were running interference for her at the DOJ.
Though it doesn't matter who violates the law.
I never underestimate the power of the American people. Remember when there were some people in the intelligence community who didn't even want to release the Nunes memo, but because tens of thousands of Americans contacted their members of Congress and demanded transparency, we got it. And that's why the American people need to back up what Lee Zeldin and many other members of Congress are fighting for, to get a second special counsel so that people are held accountable and thrown in jail for the crimes committed against the Trump administration during the transition.
All right. And finally, you know, you guys now are really pushing hard on this. Do you have meetings with the Attorney General? I mean, have you sat down with him and said, you know, maybe, you know, over a glass of milk, a glass of bourbon, I mean, whatever, and said, come on, what is the problem here?
I did sit down with the Attorney General, along with Judiciary Chairman Bob Goodlatte and many others, and I was disappointed that the Attorney General didn't seem to be very engaged on any of these issues regarding existential threats to the Trump administration. He was deferring to a team that answered to Rod Rosenstein, for goodness sakes, and it was Rosenstein's very signatures that reauthorized these wiretaps based on false information that the Department of Justice and FBI knew was false information. And so I think we need a more engaged Attorney General.
Well, was the Attorney General in the company of Rod Rosenstein at that point, or Rosenstein's chief of staff, as I understand he usually is?
It was the members of the Rosenstein team that were present, and when members of Congress asked Jeff Sessions to be more assertive and take action on a second special counsel, he deferred to staff members. I fear, Judge, that Jeff Sessions has become an employee at the Department of Justice, and he's not fulfilling his duties as Attorney General.
Wow.